Lady Lions senior guard Jacqueline Chauvin has been a leader for Southeastern the last 4 years she has been in Hammond. Chauvin has remained optimistic through the tough stretches in her playing career, which is the mentality that has been instilled in her since she was 5 years old when she lost her mother Cecilia to cancer.
Around kindergarten, my mom had gotten diagnosed with cancer. And they told her, you know, it's stage 4 pancreatic, you have about 4 months, 4 or 5 months to live, give or take, you know, a little bit of time. And at that point, my mom had had triplets and twins. So from my family's point of view, they were kind of in a situation where they were like, you know, what a blessing it is that she is still given the gift of life, you know, whether it be for another year or 4 months, whatever. You know, what a gift. You know, let's just do all we can to make sure that she can cherish it with the people she loves most.
Cliche or not, from that moment, Jacqueline chose to believe that the glass is always half full. In life and in sports, the mindset for her was to always remain positive for her and her family.
So when the good Lord called your name, it's about the memories you make. You know, what kind of difference you've made for somebody and what you can do to help others. Because life is too short and you really never know, you know, when your time will come. And I think that's what has made me into who I am.
By the age of 12, she shouldered some of the responsibility of her 3 brothers and sister. Together they leaned on each other and used sports as common ground. Her youngest brothers, Cameron and Christopher, played soccer. Her older brother, John, played baseball, while Jenna and Jacqueline were both into soccer and basketball. Their competitive nature brought out the best in one another.
She was always better than me in soccer. I mean, in basketball, but I was always better than her in soccer. So it was like a battle about what sport we were going to pick. But once we picked soccer, she was just always someone that I could chase because she was always better than me. So, I mean, she's always been, like, we've played with boys growing up our whole life. So she was always tough and she was always just very active.
Jacqueline's career flourished in basketball, becoming a standout at Fountain Blue High School. She finished her career there, averaging over 20 points and 4 assists per game, while also adding 2-time All-State and 4-time First-Team All-District to her resume. Chauvin's phenomenal career at Fountain Blue led her to getting the opportunity to play right here for the Lady Lions, in which she continued to improve while getting more playing time each year for the Green and Gold. Through those years, though, she faced many obstacles, going through numerous head coaches, but she did stay her course to be the best teammate and player she could possibly be.
But the fact that she's been here through all those coaching changes kind of tell you what kind of person and player she is because they kept her.
Jacqueline really improved each year, and that was on the court and off the court. You know, she came off the court a better leader, better, you know, she was always a good teammate, but she became an even better teammate.
Teammate turned leader as coaches came and left. Jacqueline kept her positive outlook, focused on playing her best, and forged a close bond with her teammates. She and Ashaylee Braley have spent the last 3 seasons on the court as teammates and off the court as roommates.
Ashaylee really is just the funniest, most genuine, caring, loving teammate that you'll ever really have.
My family adores Jacqueline, and being an only child, I never had a sister or any siblings to grow up around. And being here, Jacqueline definitely is like a sister to me.
And then as everything appeared to be going well for the Chauvin family, tragedy struck again as Jacqueline began her senior year. Her stepfather, Chris, was killed in an accident.
He was involved in a car wreck August 25th. He was involved in a car wreck. He was driving for Uber, and he did like a U-turn, and then somebody came and hit him. The person that hit him, they did say, was intoxicated. So maybe it could have been avoided.
Losing 2 of her parents could have left Jacqueline bitter, but instead she used her past and how she handled it to help those close to her going through a similar loss.
I dealt with some adversity also. You know, I lost my father my first year here, Christmas Day. I lost my grandmother 18 days after, then a year later I lost my grandfather. So, you know, she was there. She was at all the funerals, at all the wakes, you know, even during the middle of the season, because this was all during the middle of the season, she was there. She came to my house, brought flowers, a card. That's just the type of person that she is.
I've been so, so very lucky to have been able to use the platform that I've been given to reach out to others and to make a difference and to be that helping hand that probably a lot of people needed or have ever wanted. And I've only wanted to be able to give back just as much, if not more, than others have done for me.
Despite losing her stepdad, Jacqueline made it through her senior year, helping the Lady Lions to the most wins in a season in 6 years. She also had her best year statistically, averaging over 10 points per game, second in assists for her team, while tied for first in steals.
What Jacqueline did this year on the court and what she did in previous years was just unbelievable.
Clearly, Jacqueline's approach has made a difference on and off the court, touching the lives of everyone she's been around. Reporting for The Big Game, I'm Dylan Domingue.